Good morning, students. Once again, I welcome you to my video lectures on control systems. Now, I am further continuing with the theory of root locus by taking the next example. Open loop transfer function GSHS equal to K into S plus 5 divided by S plus 1. For the first time, I have taken 0. There is one pole and one 0. The pole is at S equal to minus 1. The pole is at S equal to minus 1. Now pole is at S equal to minus 1. And there is a 0 at S equal to minus 1. Now this is S plane. This is S plane. Mark the pole and 0. This is pole. The pole is here at S equal to minus 1. Pole at S equal to minus 1. So for pole, you use cross mark. For 0, circle. 0 at S equal to minus 5. At equal to minus 5. This is at minus 5. Now, once again, you take trial points. Now, trial points here join. Now, first, before that, I will arrange this. Mark A. Angle mark A mod S plus 5 angle theta 1 divided by mod S plus 1 angle theta 2. Theta 2 is equal to 1 plus or minus 180 degree. So this is what mod K GSHS angle K GSHS is equal to 1 plus or minus 180 degree. This is the theory of root locus. As you all know, this is the theory of root locus. Now, take angle criterion. If you take the angle criterion, theta 1 minus theta 2 is equal to plus or minus 180 degree. So this is the necessary condition, angle criterion. This is what is called as angle criterion. Theta 1 minus theta 2 is equal to plus or minus 180 degree. Now take this point, join with 0. What is this angle? This angle is theta 1. Join with this. This is angle theta 2. Both theta 1 and theta 2 are positive because angle measured in anti-clockwise direction, positive. Theta 1 is acute, theta 2 is acute. So, subtracting one acute angle from the other doesn't yield you 180 degree. Therefore, this cannot be the root locus. Now, shift the trial point. Shift here. If you shift the trial point here, then, Join this with this. This is theta 2. Because theta 2 is associated with mod S plus 1. Therefore, theta 2 is 0. What about theta 1? Theta 1 is equal to theta. Now, this is theta 2. This is theta 2. Theta 2 is 0. What about theta 1? Theta 1 is also 0. Both theta 1 and theta 2 are zeros. Therefore, we don't get plus or minus 180 degree. Therefore, this cannot be the root locus. Now, I will take trial points between minus 1 and minus 5. Between minus and minus 5, if you take trial points, join with this. If you join with this, so this is S plus 1 phasor. What is theta 2? Theta 2 is 180 degree. theta 2 is 180 degree. Next, same point joined with this, that is theta 1. What is theta? Because theta 1 is associated with s plus y. Therefore, theta 1 is horizontal, 0 degrees. So, what is 180 minus 0? So, theta 1 is 0, theta 2 is 180. If you subtract one from the other, we get 180, plus 180 or minus 180. Therefore, the root locus going to exist between minus 1 and minus 5, minus 5, and this will be the root locus. Now, the root locus, the angle criterion is satisfied. Angle criterion is satisfied. Therefore, the root locus is represented like this. Root locus. Now, apply magnitude criterion and find the magnitude, the values of k. First, at s equal to minus 1. At s equal to minus 1, magnitude criterion is mod k mod s value is minus 1. Minus 1 plus 5 divided by mod minus 1 plus 1 equal to 1. So, minus 1 plus 1, 0. If you multiply, k equal to 0. Always root locus originate at poles of GSHS with value k equal to 0. Next, take s equal to minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, any value you take. Say for example, minus 2. S equal to minus 2. So if you take s equal to minus 2, then k mod minus 2 plus 5 divided by mod minus 2 plus 1 equal to 1. Therefore, k value is equal to 5 minus 2, 3. 3. 3 minus 2 plus 1 minus 1 mod minus 1 is 1. Therefore, k is equal to 1 by 3. K equal to 1 by 3. K equal to 1 by 3. So, at s equal to minus 2, k value is 1 by 3. Because k value should increase from 0 and must end with infinity. Lastly, at minus 5. At minus 5, mod k mod minus 5 plus 5 divided by mod minus 5 plus 1 equal to 1. Therefore, what is k value? Minus 5 plus 5 means 0. So, minus 5 plus 1 means mod 4. Mod minus 4, that is 4. So, 4 divided by 0, that is infinity. Therefore, it is going to terminate at k equal to at s equal to minus 5, because in this problem we have taken 0. In the other previous examples I have not taken zeros. So for the first time I have taken 0. Always root locus branches originate at the poles of GSHS and terminate at the zeros or at infinity. In this problem there is a 0. Therefore, the root locus branch is terminating at this 0, that is at s equal to minus 5. In the next class, I will work out the last problem, and I hope that the students have followed the theory of root locus. Thank you.